lush life.
My name is Zoe Cowan, and I'm Gabriel Cowan's mom. And I'm here to talk to you today about the kind of music that I like to listen to when I was Gabe's age. When I was 18, I was going to school. I was in college at the University of Arkansas in beautiful Fayetteville, Arkansas. And I liked a lot of different types of music. I liked classical music, like Bach and Chopin. I liked a lot of jazz, like Charlie Parker and Miles Davis, John Coltrane, especially Lush Life. Who wouldn't want to be sitting in some small dive in Paris? Of course, I also like bands like The Who and Bob Marley, Jimmy Cliff. But I remember when we finally discovered Patti Smith. Patti Smith was, she still is a singer who lives up in New York City. And when we first got her album, we couldn't believe it.
Jesus,
she was amazing. She didn't give a damn what she looked like. She was this really skinny woman with her hair going every which way. But she was a poet. And her lyrics were amazing. Her band was great. She had this incredible energy. And it just opened up this whole new world of music. Of the underground punk scene was happening. And I moved, I transferred to American University in Washington, D.C., which was the heart of the punk music movement that was happening right then in the early 80s. And I was lucky enough to be involved with a fanzine called Truly Needy. And I got to go and interview a lot of bands. And we had a lot of local bands too, like Minor Threat and Bad Brains. And it was a really great time. It was there was so much new music happening and so much energy and vibrancy coming out of this scene. And you know, and eventually I went back to Patti Smith, because that's what you go back to. And the thing that really got me out of Arkansas and got me to move to Washington, that inspired me to move to a bigger city. And several years ago, Gabe's dad and I went to one of her concerts at the 930 Club. And it was really funny because there were all these people there who were old, and they had brought their kids with them. And so it was just so funny. And it was really telling that she had, you know, moved so many people, and people still love her today.